first, just hours before the fight between DPS and the teachers heads to court. We're learning students are planning to protest outside of Cass Tech High School. A group of students now say tomorrow morning they will join together and demand the district do something about the poor conditions at their schools.
And tomorrow, the district and the teachers are set to square off in a courtroom. Priya Mann joins us live now. Priya, I know you've been in touch with some teachers today. Are more sick outs planned?
That's the big question, and it really depends on who you talk to. Now, the union says the majority of teachers named in this lawsuit are urging their colleagues to stay in the classroom. But Steve Kahn, who's named in this lawsuit, and his supporters want every teacher, parent, and student at the courthouse tomorrow.
We plan on urging everyone to come out to this.
Steve Kahn says parents should be prepared for school closings on Monday due to teacher sickouts. A judge could decide tomorrow whether to implement an injunction against 23 Detroit teachers and organizations named in a DPS lawsuit.
I think what we have to convince her of is that if ever there was a moment to rise to the occasion and to act in the interests of the people of Detroit, it's now.
A fractured union is coming together, denouncing the district for going after its teachers.
It's a waste of money. It's a waste of money. And like I said, I'm very disappointed. Why is it continuing that you want to punish teachers?
Kahn says the focus shouldn't be on public educators, but on those in office.
We intend to put Early and Snyder on trial. We have testimony, people who will testify, about all the irreparable harm damage they've done to the schools.
Detroit public school teachers say buildings are falling apart and that students don't have access to basic resources.
This is a social movement aimed at restoring political power to the people of Detroit, democracy to Black and Latino communities all across the state.
Now, the district says these teacher sickouts and forced school closings are hurting kids, that this is time in the classroom students aren't getting, and now they're using the court system to push through this issue. And it is interesting to note that they also did release a statement today. But last week, it's important to note that a judge did side with the teachers, refusing to issue a temporary restraining order halting these teacher sickouts. So we will be following these developments closely. Reporting live from the West Side, I'm Priya Mann, Local 4.
Priya, of course, you spoke with the teachers. Did you speak with anybody from the district today?
That's right. DPS did release a statement. I'll read just a short portion of it. It says Detroit Public Schools believes that it's extremely important that the court play a role in the resolution of this serious issue. We look forward to the opportunity to inform the court of the serious effects that these continued sickouts are having on the district, its students, and their families. Steve Zander, back to you.
Big day tomorrow in court. Thank you, Priya.